We have completed question number 1 of exercise 3.3. Now, today we are going to begin with the question number 2. So, let's see the question. Question number 2 is, students, using the divisibility test, determine which of the following number are divisible by 4 and by 8. That means, see here, these numbers have been given to you and you have to tell that whether these numbers are divisible by 4, by 8 or not, right? So, first number is 572, students. There are three rules in divisibility of 4 as well as 8. In 4, the rule is last two digits should be divisible by 4. Second, last two digits should have 0. Or third rule is also there, that is divide the entire number by 2 times. Similarly, for 8 also we are having, that is last three digits should be divided by 8. Last three digits should have 0. Or last three digits, you have to divide the entire number by 2 3 times, right? So this is the rule of 4 and 8. So based on rule only I have done this. So let's see one by one. See, last digit 72 is divisible by 4. Yes. This three digits, last three digits should be checked for 8. 572. It is not divisible by 8. So I have put a cross over there. Last two digits, 52. Yes, it is divisible by 4. Last three digits, 352. It is divisible by 8. 8 fours are 32. And again, 4 will come. So, 44s are 352 is there. See, last two digits are 0. So, it is divisible by 4. Last two digits are 0. That's why it is not divisible by 8. For 8 to happen, last three digits should have 0. Right? Last three digits are 0. So, yes, it is divisible by 4 as well as 8. Dono se ho jayega. 59, it is not divisible by both because 59 is an odd representative. So, 4 and 8, both are even numbers. It is not going to be divided by these numbers. 60, yes, it is divisible by 4. 4, 15, sir. And 560, that is also divisible by 8. Last two digits, 84. Yes, it is divisible by 4. Last three digits, 84. It is not divisible by 8. 8 ke table mein 84 kabhi nahi aata, right? So, next number. Last two digits are 72. Yes, it is divisible by 4. Last three digits, 72. It is divisible by 8. 9 are 72. Last two digits are 0. So, yes, it is divisible by 4. And last three digits, see, 700. So, 700, we cannot divide it by 8 because it's 7 is an odd. So, we cannot divide it by 8. 150, last two digits are 50, so it is not divisible by 4 because 4 ke table mein 50 nahi aata. Last three digits 150, it's no because again it is representing an odd number only, right? So this is for the question number 2, students. Okay, students, now see the question number 3. Question number 3 is, using the divisibility test, determine which of the following numbers are divisible by 6. So, to check whether the number is divisible by 6 or not, students, first we need to see whether the number is divisible by 2 and 3, both, right? Both word means 2 se bhi hona chahiye or 3 se bhi hona chahiye. If it is divisible by both 2 and 3, then it is divisible by 6. Agar dono mein se koi ek bhi agar divisible nahi hai, so the 6 will also not going to happen, right? So, if both are agreed, then 6 will be there. So let's see one question from it, right? First of all, 297144. To check whether it is divisible by 2 or not, last digit should be even. So see, the last digit is 4, so that is even, so it is divisible by 2, right? Now, to check whether it is given by 3 or not, we need to add the entire digits of the given number. So 2 plus 9, it is 11. 11 plus 7, 18. Plus 1, 19 plus 4, 23 plus 4, 27. Yes. So the total is coming 27, which is divisible by 3. So if both are agreed, then you can say 6 is also right. Is it okay to all of you? Similarly, you can do the remaining questions also, right? First, check whether it is given by 2. If it is yes and 3 is saying no, then definitely it is not going to be divisible by 6. If dono mein yes aa raha hai, to hi wo yes hoga. Is it clear to all of you? Okay, students, now we'll see the next question, that is question number 4, right? Using the divisibility test, determine which of the following numbers are divisible by 11. So here we need to check the divisibility rule of 11, right? So whether the numbers are divisible by 11 or not. So what is the rule of 11, student? The rule of 11 is you have to add the digits which are at the odd places and you have to add the digits which are at the even places. Their sum should be either, the difference should be either 0 or it should be divisible by 11. Their difference should be either 0 or it should be divisible by 11. Then the number is divisible by 11. So let's see these questions now. First one, students, 5, 4, 4, 5. So the digit which are at the odd places are at, you can start from right side or left side, doesn't matter, right? Generally we start from the left side only, from the right side only, but you can start from the left side also. So 5 and 4 will get 9, and this 4 and this 5 will get 9. So the difference of these two numbers is 0. So yes, this number is divisible by 11. Next number, 10824. So I'm adding the odd places digits, right? And simultaneously you add the even places digits also. So 0 plus 2 is 2, 1 plus 8 9, and 9 plus 4 it is 13. So the difference 13 minus 2, that is 11, right? So either the difference should be 0 or it should be divisible by 11. So if I subtract 13 and 2, I'll get 11. So 11 we can divide by 11. So yes, this is divisible by 11. Okay, next one, 7138965. This is your number, students. So this is my odd place digit. This is also my odd place digit. Odd place digit and odd place. So 7 plus 3, 10. 10 plus 9, 19. And 19 plus 5, students, it's 24. 1 plus 8 plus 6. So 6 plus 8, 14. Plus 1, 15. So if I subtract that, 24 minus 15, I get, students, 9. Right? So 9 is not divisible by 11. So here I am writing, no, it is not divisible by 11. Next one, students, 7, then 1, then 9, then 0, right? So 7 plus 1, 8, 8 plus 9, 17, plus 0, it is 17 only, 0, then 6, then 3, and then 8, right? 0 plus 6, it is 6, 6 plus 3, 9, and 9 plus 8, 17. So the difference 17 minus 17 comes as 0. Yes, so it is divisible by 11. Next one, this one. So 1, then 0, then 0, then 0. Right? So it's 1, 0, 0, this 0, and this 1. If I add, then I get 1. So the difference of 1 minus 1, it comes as 0. So yes, it is divisible by 11. Last one, friends, 901153, right? So this is 9, this 1, this 5, right? So 9 plus 1, 10, and 10 plus 5, 15. 9 plus 1, 10, 10 plus 5, 15. And the even plus digit 0, this 1, and this 3. So 3 plus 1, it is 4, and 4 plus 0 is 4. So the difference 15 minus 4 is 11, students. So 11 is divisible by 11. So here this is also divisible by 11, right? So now see the question number 5, right? Question number 5, students, write the smallest digit and the greatest digit in the blank space of each of the following numbers so that the number formed is divisible by 3. The number formed is divisible by 3. So here we have to insert one digit smallest and one digit greatest so that it is divisible by 3. So first let's add the digits and get that what the sum is actually coming. So 4 plus 2 it is 6, 6 plus 7 it is 13, and 13 plus 6 19. So 19 is not divisible by 3. So if I add 1 to it, so okay, first we'll start from 0, the smallest digit, right? So if I add 0, 19 plus 0 is 19 only. 19, then I move on to 1. So 19 plus 1, I get 20. So 20 is not divisible by 3. Then I take 2. So 19 plus 2, I get 21. Yes, 21 is divisible by 3, right? So the smallest digit I can write as, that is 2. Right? Now we'll add 3. Then 19 plus 3 becomes 22. Not divisible. Then 19 plus 4. We add, then I get 9 plus 4 is 23. Again not divisible. 19 plus 5, I get 24. Yes, 24 is divisible by 3, but it's not yet the greatest digit. 6, 19 plus 6, agar hum yahan pe 6 rakhenge, to 19 plus 6, it will become 25. It's not divisible. 19 plus 7, 26, not divisible by 3. 19 plus 7, if I add, then I will get 26, right? 19 plus 8, if I add 9 and 8, I get 27. So yes, it can be divisible by 3. Last 19 plus 9, because the greatest digit generally jise hum mante hai wo hai 9. So 19 ko agar hum 9 ke saath add karenge, so we'll get 28. So 28 is not divisible by 3. So here we can consider the greatest digit as 28. Right, because 19 or 8, agar aap add karenge, so we'll get 27, which is divisible by 3. Similarly, we'll work on this question also. Smallest digit and the greatest digit here also we need to find. Okay, first of all, we'll check what is the sum of these numbers, or sum of this digit, sorry. 4 plus 7, 11. 4 plus 7, 11. 11 plus 6, 17. 17 plus 5, 22. 22 plus 2, we get 24. Yes, 24 itself is a divisible by 3. So, greatest, smallest digit kya hona chahiye fir? So, agar hum dekhe, the smallest digit should be 0. Students, now we'll see the greatest digit, right? So, greatest digit ke liye, hum log ne pehle 0 ko try kiya. Now, we'll move on to the 1. So 24, if you add 1, it will become 25, which is not divisible by 3. Then give the chance to 2. 24 plus 2, it will become 26, not divisible by 3. 3 ko chance deje. 24 plus 3, 27. Yes, but it is not the smallest, it is not the greatest digit. 24 plus 3, 27, divisible by 3, but it is not the greatest digit. Then 24, then plus 4, we get 28, not divisible by 3. 24 plus 5, it's 29. Divisible by 3. 24 plus 6, 30. Yes, it is divisible by 3, but it is right now not the greatest digit. 24 plus 7, 7 plus 4, 31. Not divisible by 3. So 24 plus 8, we get 32. Again, not divisible by 3. 24 plus 9, because generally 9 ko hum greatest digit mante hain. So 24 plus 9, we get 33. Yes, 33 is divisible by 3. So here smallest digit 0 aya or greatest digit is your 9. 24 in sabka apne sum kiya, so we get 24 plus 9, we get 33. So yes, it is divisible by 3. Right? I hope students we understood this much. Okay students, now let's see the last question of this exercise, right? Question number 6, right? A digit in the blank space of each of the following number. So that the number formed is divisible by 11, right? So here you can see this number, right? But one digit is missing in this number, 92-389. So we have to fill that digit with such a number so it becomes divisible by 11, right? So first of all, we'll see the sum of odd places and the sum of even places, right? What actually it is coming. So this is my first odd places, first odd place. Then this is my second odd place. This is my third odd place. So 9, we don't have anything, plus 8, so 9 plus 8 is 17, plus question mark. Now even place, this is first digit of this even place, this is 2, then this 3 and this 9. So 9 plus 3 is 12 and 12 plus 2 it is 14, right? Now which number students should we keep over here so that when we add these two numbers, the difference between this and 14 should be divisible by 11. So for that we need to work out, right? So see here, 17, for example, if I keep 0, so my answer comes as 70. And if I subtract by 40, I get 3. So it is not divisible by 11. So I'm putting cross. Now 17 plus 1, I get 18. 18 minus 40 is 4, not divisible by 11. 17 plus 2, I get 90. 6 not divisible by 11. 17 plus 4, I am get 21. Minus 14, so 7 not divisible by 11. 17 plus 5, I get 22. If I subtract 14 from it, I will get 8. So again not divisible by 11, right? 17 plus 6, I get 23. If I subtract 14 from it, I get 19. Not divisible by 11, right? 17 plus 7, I get 24. Minus 14, I get 10. Not divisible by 11. Until and unless we don't get something which is divisible by 11, we cannot complete the process. 17 plus 8, I think that here we can get. So 11, yes, it is divisible by 11. So the missing digit is your 8. Missing digit is students 8. The same procedure needs to be done in the second one also, right? For the weak question also. So see, first we'll add odd places, 8, then 9, then 8. So 8 plus 8 16, and 16 plus 9 is 25, right? This 4 and 4, so 4 plus 4 is 8. 8 plus question 1. So what needs to be added with the 8, and when we subtract from 25, we'll get something which is divisible by 11. Right. So let's work out for this also, students, right? So 8 plus 0, if I add, then I get 8, and if I subtract it from 25, I am getting 17. So 17 is not divisible by 11. Now 8 plus 1, I get 9, and if I subtract this 9 from this 25, I get 16. Again it is not divisible by 11. 8 plus 2, if I add 8 and 2, I get 10, and 10, if I subtract from 25, I get 15, not divisible by 11. 8 plus 3, I get 11. 25 minus 11, I will get 40, so it's not divisible by 11. 8 plus 4, it's 12, and if I subtract this 12 from this 25, so I get 13, so it's not divisible by 11, right? 8 plus 5 is 13, and 25 minus 13, I get 12, it's not divisible by 11. 8 plus 6, I get 14, and 25 minus 14, it's 11, yes, it is divisible by 11. So the missing digit right here is 6, right? So my missing digit is 6. Is it clear to all of you? Right? Abhar.